Hello everyone, Demosthenes here. I'm hoping to do a playthrough for the level Homecoming. This is the level directly after retaking series, and for those of you that may have struggled in retaking series, I have a video out for how I proceeded to beat it. And as I mentioned in that video, Homecoming is a different kind of nightmare. It was for me, at least. I know a lot of the other alpha testers did not struggle at all. But that reason, at least from my understanding, is I've developed a lot of really, really bad habits in terms of navigating the solar system. So I didn't quite develop a really good understanding of the orbital mechanics and astrogation, you might say. Yeah, I did enough to get by, and it worked up until now. Let me show you one of the really bad habits that I did develop before I show you what's necessary to actually beat the level.
Incoming transmission.
First thing, we have Themis orbiting the sun, and we have Mars. We need to get to Mars because there is a cargo station orbiting Mars, and this cargo station is out of plane, not only for Mars, the Mars orbit, excuse me, it's out of plane for that, in addition to being out of plane, like, our orbit is currently out of plane of Mars, so, two transitions there, and let's jump right into how not to beat this level. First, I select my tanker. Now what I'm going to do here is, thankfully I'm over here on this edge of the orbit, and I'm going to, ideally you want to use these nodal points, point nearest, so that's bad, point crosses, point farthest from the orbited body. Unfortunately it takes me 6 months just to get around Themis to get there. So, we're going to say screw it, we're just going to use this spot right here and get away from Themis, and we're going to do it all in one burn. We're not actually going to. That's the problem I developed while playing all the previous levels, was I was able to do all the burns, whether it was a combat mission, I would do all my intercepts with typically one burn. And all the space traveling missions I would do in one burn as well. Whether it's out of plane, in plane, any sort of intercept, I would do one burn to get there and then one burn to intercept. And so I went into this level with that same mentality, knowing it would be on a much larger scale, much farther distance, greater time allotment. And I tried to do that for a while. Let me show you really quick. So I'm going to tighten that orbit in, getting closer to Mars. First I'm going to use Mars as kind of the spot that I want to get to. And already you see we're running into an issue here where I can't even, having a hard time actually intersecting and getting close. I've also noticed the calculations are causing some issues. There we go. Looks like we're finally getting over there. I'm gonna focus my camera on Mars. And I'm gonna attempt to pull that trajectory in really, really tight. Adjust my plane. Bring it down, we're getting on the orbit, so right now we could potentially match the orbit of Mars. That's what a smart person would do, not me. We're gonna attempt, once again, like I said, two burns, one burn to get there, break orbit from Themis, go all the way across the solar system, adjust for the intercepts and everything, and then one burn to connect. So right now we're only burning 4.9 kilometers per second, so We're still kind of far out there, but let's see what kind of burn it'll take to join. Not good, huh? Yeah. Don't have nearly enough fuel for that, and if I recall, I don't think there's a single ship in the game that'll allow you to pull something like that off. So, go back to a burn, maybe we can adjust it, get it over there, a little bit closer. Now we got it after, join. We're still at 100. Long story short, there's literally no way to pull this off the way I'm trying to do it. So hopefully this will save you guys some trouble when you realize that this whole idea of nice, beautiful OCPD one burn levels, it's not going to work. It's not how NASA does it. It's not... It doesn't work in this. And there's multiple reasons for it, so... Let's,
Incoming transmission.
There we go, reading. So we're going to the recommended reading. And thankfully the developer has put in... absolutely mandatory reading for this, this level. So first he goes over long distance trajectories. He says if you need to alter your trajectory, it's cheapest in terms of delta V to do so as far away as possible. Well, we already did that, right? Like, what was our problem? If you're injecting into a moon's orbit from far away, you need to change your orbital inclination when you arrive. It's far cheaper to make the required inclination burn long before you enter the moon's orbit. So that's kind of what I was doing, right? Here at the last sentence, he says, one of the related note on long distance transfers involving the celestial body is that injecting into a circular orbit around that body after such a long distance is often the cheapest and simplest way to get captured by that body. There lies point number one that's very, very necessary for us. So we need to inject into the Mars orbit. So once we've done our long trajectory to get over there, we want to inject into Mars, get captured, orbit around, and then from there, it should in theory be just like our previous levels where we're just doing nice little Hohmann transfers from one body to the next, or just trying to intercept craft orbiting the same body as ours. So that's long distance trajectories. We have low acceleration maneuvers. This is where he's talking about the acceleration that you need. So yeah, I think if you try to use the belt trawlers that he gives you, the acceleration is extremely low. Part of the issue you're going to run into is it'll take you forever to get there. And like he says here, good acceleration for getting around the solar system is 100 millig's or greater. Yeah. So I think you can get, like, the belt trawlers are just, like, abysmal, and some of the other, like, the methane tanker, how many? 100 millig's. Is that about the same? Oh, apparently 100 millig's is just fine, then. I did some experimentation with much higher acceleration craft, but I guess for this level, we don't necessarily need to address that. So multi-stage trajectories. This one seems like it applies to us. Getting to the destination a single burn or few burns will likely be extremely difficult or impossible. This may be a direct statement at me after banging my head against a developer for a while, trying to figure out what I was doing wrong. So. Once multiple bodies are to be considered, multiple burns, at least one per body, are often very necessary. So, what that means is two burns, because we have Themis and we have Mars. Very important one, if I could underline it. One burn to escape each orbit, one burn to inject into each orbit. So, that's two burns right there, and then there's a burn in between that he doesn't mention here. He may discuss a little bit down here, but the burn to get between your celestial bodies. So here in the example, You consider a spacecraft orbiting the moon of Jupiter with the destination of a space station orbiting the moon of Saturn. May apply to us. First, a burn must be made to break free of the moon. Then that puts a spacecraft in orbit around Jupiter. Second burn, break free of Jupiter, putting the craft in orbit around Sol. So what it's telling us is first we need to get out of Themis's orbit and get into orbit around Sol. And then we need a burn that must be made to actually get a flyby of Saturn. So now we need to actually truck across the solar system. So that's burn number two. And then a burn must be made to inject into orbit around Saturn. In our case, it'll be Mars. And then, of course, we need to use another burn to get to the to intercept the space station. So this one right here helps me out. It's very necessary if you're in the same kind of like obsessive compulsive idea of I want to make this one pretty burn. You know, you're not going to be able to do that, not unless you have some magical spaceship. Orbital escape. Actually, at this point, I think we're good to go. Rocket power, rocket thrust, discusses kind of limits and what you need to be working with. I'm just going to say, I already know that this level can be beat with a large methane tanker, so we're going to go with that. So, jump right back in, and let's try this out. First, we need our first burn to escape Themis. So thankfully, we're actually kind of on the inside, so to speak. I don't know if that helps us. We could do the orbital node, we could do the farthest point. That seems promising, but that's also 3 months away. And we're gonna try to get there as fast as possible. So let's just burn right where we are. And we're just gonna push ourselves out of that orbit, just a burn approximately. We're gonna use two. We don't actually need that much. We can use a small burn. Cause Themis, I don't even know. What's the how big is Themis? 2.3 to 19 kilograms? Nothing compared to a lot of the other celestial bodies we're working with. By comparison, form factors of magnitude higher. Yeah. So, we're not too concerned about that. The majority of our fuel is going to be used, not the majority, but a chunk of our fuel will be used to get to Mars, a chunk of it to inject into a circular orbit around Mars, and then the last little bit to intersect the station should be trivial once we actually get inject into orbit. So here's our first little burn. I'm just gonna do a little bit more, just to speed it up a little bit. Let's do one kilometer per second. Arbitrary value. Once again, a little bit of the OCPD shining through. There we go. Well, not perfect. Screw it, we're doing it. And this is an immediate burn, so I can just 10 minutes, and there we are. We should now be not necessarily, there we go. So once we hit this spot right here, we're orbiting Sol. So if I, let's see where we'll be in an hour. Let's just get to that point. What that means is we could potentially right there do a burn. Orbit. That should inject us back into Themis, which is actually not what we want to do. So let's go burn for another hour. Doesn't look like it's giving us the trajectory. Screw it. In theory, we've got a decent amount of burn. We should be out of the gravity well so that the effects aren't too great for us. And let's go trucking across the solar system. Select Mars as your frame of reference. And let's see how much fuel it takes to get over there. Seems a little bit costly still. Not a fan of that, so I'm gonna try to minimize it. There we go. No, we're not going as fast, but we're conserving some of our fuel. I'm actually going to... yeah. Over there, that's 11 months. We got a year in 11 months. So that takes us from here. We got a year to intersect with Mars. In theory, should be fine. I'm gonna get over there a little bit faster. Let's see if we can speed that up. Let's tighten that orbit. Now we're using 6 of our 20. And that'll be a year to pretty much close with. And then if we say match Mars orbit, it's not gonna be pretty. So what I'm gonna do is we're gonna accelerate over there, and then as we start getting closer, like the notes say, we wanna do burns as far away from the bodies as possible. It's a little bit more efficient that way because we're not fighting with the planets at that point, or fighting with the gravitational effects of the planets. So we'll just wing it. We're gonna start burning. We're gonna shift it to a month. So here we go. Okay, so now at around this spot, I'm actually gonna start. I'm gonna see about doing another burn. Like I said, you wanna do your burns as far away from your bodies as possible. And then that allows us, once we get close, we can start trying to figure out how to inject into orbit without emptying our fuel tanks. Oops. What we're actually trying to do here is, to a certain degree, kind of slow down so that we, relative to Mars, so that this burn, this interception burn, isn't so costly for us. Of course, right now, that's not happening. Oops, too far. What I want to do is, once I hit this point, we know we're coming in towards Mars, and I'm just going to burn in the opposite direction a bunch in an attempt to slow down so that I can get captured by Mars. As you can see here, even though I'm pulling on this, the green thrust, it's actually, you know, I'm still able to maintain the trajectory going through Mars. Pull that out a little bit. Let's see what it looks like. There we go. So now we're actually below what we wanted to, but that's not going to leave us much to intercept. So let's cancel that one. Let's actually try to pull it off way back here. So once again, let's try to go opposite direction. I don't know if we're going to be able to do it out here that far. Alright, so we got a burn away from our target. We're going to be coming in, match Mars orbit, and we're still a little bit over. Push it out even further? Maybe not. There we go, that's a nice looking number. So about 10 kilometers per second to match Mars, and then from there that'll give us about 10 kilometers to intercept the station. Let's actually see if we can. So right now we're really high above the orbital plane of the station, so let's try to push it down. As we push it down, it also has some other effects that we need to compensate for. And this may be a pipe dream, because trying to match with that station is just bloody nightmare. Let's see what this gives us. We've got an orbital node, maybe we can match it. Nope. Screw it. Let's oops. Let's try to go back to what we had and burn in the opposite direction. Oops. Oh, that's why. Once again, just trying to match Mars. One step at a time. There, even better than before. Yeah. So let's give that a shot. That'll be 8 months from now, 10 months. We're gonna be cutting it close. Actually, we won't be cutting it too close. Still give us about 5 months leeway. To rendezvous with the station, which, like I said, should be trivial once we're orbiting Mars. Oops. There we go. Alright. Let's maybe check and see if we need to make any last minute corrections. Alright, so. Interesting looking burn. So we're above the plane of Mars, and there's our little, and we're gonna be out there, but if you have faith in me, once we get into orbit around Mars, shouldn't be too bad. Looks like a whole series of burn burns that away, and then that one to pretty much counteract all of our blue trajectory, so to speak. Pretty much since we came from Themisto at a different orbital inclination. Alright, so now let's focus on Mars. Let's see. It's 1 month still, so a few days. There we go. So now we're in orbit around Mars, orbiting Sol. So now let's get to the station. Set frame of reference to be the cargo station. What happens. So that's a pretty ugly little orbit. Part of that is because we're at a don't want to say the resolution limits, but kind of that same idea of it's having a really difficult time calculating out all your trajectories because we have the entire, not the entire, a huge chunk of the solar system being calculated out, and we're trying to do, you know, astronomically small orbits now on a huge scale. For reference, this would be like, I don't know. We've got, you know, you're using a meter stick and you're kind of, you know, measuring stuff in a lab, say a distance between your, you know, lasers and mirror setups. You're using a meter stick for that. But to actually get, you know, your, say your beam width or your beam width to the spot that you want it to be, you know, it's actually required that you have, you know, a scanning electron microscope to conduct that measurement because we're on, say, the micron scale. So that's where you're going to start running into problems when you're trying to work within your entire lab room, but you actually need your SEM to complete your experiment. So here we go. Looks like we're gonna crash into Mars over there, but before we do, we're gonna try. Oof, that is not pretty. There we go. We're seeing the beautiful green symbol. That means if we're lucky, bam, 1.4 out of 5.5. Easy. And that'll only take us about 2 months to get there. So I guess we are a ways out, and we are going to cut it really close. No gold for us today. Look at that baby spin. Okay. And should be maybe 1-2 grains. Cutting it really close.
There incoming transmission.
Bronze. So, thanks for watching the video. I hope you guys learned some stuff. I haven't gotten too far past this point. After this level is best to overkill, which there's already a video tutorial out for on how to beat that level, and then after that is On the Shoulders of Giants, which is the current level I'm on, actually. On the Shoulder of Giants requires some of that same knowledge that we learned from this level. So hopefully moving forward, if any of you guys develop some bad habits or did not get a full understanding of how to conduct efficient burns traversing the solar system, hopefully this tutorial kind of helped you a little bit. Till next time.